Swiggity Sony, let's get that booty.
Yibbity scoop doop 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 doop. I don't know. I might come, I might go, I don't know. What up, though? Hello, everybody. Welcome to another episode of the Slim Cogcast. It is I, Slim Cognito. And, boy, I gotta tell y'all, this week has been some shit here. YouTube, I'm liking when you, like, curse in the first minute or something like that. Or something. I forgot. But anyway, this is a grown folks channel, to be honest with you. It's a lot going on with Sony, you know, making certain decisions. And, you know, of course, we got more stuff about hackers this week. But first, let me tell you about the anime I've been watching. Now, of course, as usual, y'all know I'm keeping up with My Hero. And here's the thing about My Hero. They're going through this whole point about the villain academia thing. And it's very interesting to me. However, it's in that realm where I wanted to, like, finish so I can just binge that part. I don't want to wait a week to see them grow exactly, because these villains, although they are, you know, not as interesting as I am used to in American, you know, superhero villains, which are very well written and for the most part very well, you know, implemented into their stories. And anyone who disagrees just does not read comic books. Like, we just got to be real here. Anime does a lot of things that the Western media does not do good, but you got to give credit where it's due. When it comes to comic books, America killed that shit. I ain't gonna say the first time, but they killed that shit, like, really, really good. And honestly, it's the comic books that inspired a lot of manga. So here's the thing. These villains, these so-called villain academias, you know, blah, 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 they are interesting because I want to see what they become. I want to see them go through shit. The thing about the heroes is that we see their tragedies and their, you know, hardships, and it makes us like the heroes more. I've never been more of an Endeavor stan than I ever have in my entire life. Like, this right here. I know I'm speaking like how I hear academia is like 20 plus years old, but still, it's like, this is where your story should be going. And if you're gonna have some type of offbeat episode that's not full of action and driving home the main plot, that's what you should be showing us. However, the villains, I don't know how to feel, you know, I kind of get a bit of a, you know, my empathy has a little room for, you know, everything I touch turns to dust. I got the opposite of the Midas touch. Well, yeah, it's just worse. And you know, I've ruined my family as a kid. You know, that's tragic, you know, and they touched on that a little bit earlier. But seeing them trying to flesh that out, I guess, is great. And, you know, really getting to look at how he grew up and things and whatnot. So everything that they're setting up to do, hopefully this builds up into something good, because I don't want to see now another Nomu fight. Fuck a Nomu, fuck a Chimera beast, whatever the goddamn, all that shit, get rid of it, alright? No more Nomus. We've been fighting Nomus since season one. No more. Tired of this shit. Tired of the Nomus, tired of this shit, tired of it as a collective. Tired of this shit. And not saying that I hate the Nomus, but that's been our main villain outside of old boy that was selling to take away your drugs, take away your power drugs. And you know, what we get out of the movies, every time, you know, we need a MacGuffin to get beat the fuck up, but it's strong as hell, and give us a reason for our heroes to go plus ultra. Let's throw a Nomu in that bit. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's a bit much. It's kind of like how Naruto used to reanimate everybody at the least convenience. Like in the original Naruto, you remember it was like, reanimation jutsu, that's forbidden. And then suddenly we get to Shippuden and niggas are popping out the grave left and right. Like, it's so, I just want to know what the hell. Either way, I'm still enjoying it though. I think I've spoiled myself, and I'm gonna go ahead and let myself be behind like a few more episodes so I could just binge through this shit and catch up to the good stuff that you want to look forward to every week. That being said, the streets is talking about Shang-Chi like crazy. I don't need to go peep that shit. I'm probably gonna watch it today, to be honest with you. So yeah, keep that on the horizon. And I might have to watch it today because my stream schedule already be crazy and I'd be ready to go to sleep like right after I get through streaming. So that's already a given. But yeah, that's what I've been watching this week for the most part in detail. Anything that y'all would care about, you know, anything in the interest and the focus of this her podcast, you feel me? But yeah, and now other things. I just want to give a quick shout out to, if you like retro games, if you like weird retro games, bad obscure games, stuff like that, or you know what I'm saying, you watch streams on a regular basis, you have to not only check out yours truly, but also check out, shout out to my boy Big Tall Not Small. He's over there on Twitch doing a original Xbox challenge, and he's trying to beat every single original Xbox game in the library, every single one. And he just recently, a few hours ago, beat Dino Crisis 3, and that shit was painful to watch. And I'm sure it was way more painful to play. But anyway, shout out to Mechalavos, which is a guy who plays a lot of really obscure old PC games, and he's doing a PlayStation 1 challenge, where a lot of point-and-click games from the PS1 are getting played on there, and they are super creepy, weird, and busted. It's very cringe, but also meme-worthy. I don't know how to describe it. I can't land on, like, one or a few words. It more words keep popping up. They're so obtuse and overwhelming, yet lackluster. I don't know what to call it, so we just gonna keep it kicking. And also one more shout out, I just gotta say shout out to, damn, who was I about to shout out? Wait a minute, god damn, I forgot it was supposed to be a third person and I forgot who the third person was. All right, now y'all have to check out, if y'all like the way I am, you gotta check out Peanut the Kidnapper over on Twitch. Shout out to my boy. Shout out. These are just people I like to watch and have had a good time conversing with. But also their content is great. Alright. Hysteric Moon X. Literally just finishing up Deadly Premonition like today. You know, first playthrough. There's a lot of good people out there. Just be on the lookout. You gonna see me around. You might catch me in one of the chats. You might see me in your favorite streamer's chat. Who knows? But with all that being said, shout out to other creators of my ilk as well, like I'm Just Key and Lifted Senses. And now if you can't tell, I'm having a grand time just meeting people and connecting with people. I'm gonna be real with y'all just for a minute, all right? Not to make it like political or nothing. I'm for real just gonna skate by this real saying, just real quick say, I'm surprised at the amount of black people that I've been able to connect with through Twitch. Like, you ever had that feeling where you could tell you met your type of, like, setting or your type of people that you would hang with, or, you know, who you would be around, you know what I'm saying, if you were to, like, be at a party or something, or, you know, if you met them back at school, who you would probably, you know what I'm saying, be cool with? It's that type of feeling. Like, you could tell that, you know what I mean, y'all be on the same type of shit. You know what I mean? All it takes is just finding other black weeaboos, other black people who, like, is big on retro games, you know what I'm saying? Classic RPGs, good stuff, you know what I mean? The arts, you know, good at painting, music, etc., etc., you know, stuff like that. People who strive for something and have something to lose, you know? And I dig it, you feel me? The good and bad side to that. But let's focus on the good, and I dig it, you know what I mean? This ain't something I'm used to. So anyway, all that being said, let's stop the wholesome here and jump right off into the news. Shit. First thing on the docket, Kotaku.com, which is, honestly, this is one of the stories that really just hit me with it, because I'm surprised that they was willing to do this, but at the same time, it's like, why are they doing this? And we got Sony said that they will no longer offer free next-gen upgrades for its first-party games. So to sum it up, after Horizon Forbidden West, PS4 owners will get a free upgrade to the PS5. But after that, there will be no more free upgrades from PS4 to the PS5 version of games. You will have to pay a $10 fee to get the PS5 version of a game from here on out. And one, you know, Let's be real. $10 from everybody. If a million people bought this shit, like, it's easy math, bro. You literally sitting on 10 mil. So I'm just gonna say, wait, is that math right? I don't know. Y'all let me know if I'm right or wrong. But I'm just gonna say this. Honestly, to get a game on a better piece of hardware, $10 is not bad. You feel me? It's not that bad. But at the same time, if it's the same game and it's just running on better hardware, people should not have to pay extra. You literally don't do nothing when it comparing it to PS4 and then the 5. It would make no sense for you to completely make a game and literally not make it to minimum or recommended requirement to be the weaker hardware. Therefore, you could just dial it up and bump up resolution and other settings on your greater hardware counterpart. You know what I mean? So I don't feel like, I feel like that's a dumb thing to do. But either way, it's a hard thing to really get a call on. You know what I mean? Like, it's either this or that with plenty, but this one right here, it's kind of up in the air. Some people care, some people don't. I just wouldn't be comfortable, you know. If you went from a PS4 to a PS5, then you already spent like $500, maybe $600. An extra $10 ain't gonna hurt you for one game. But if you gotta pay $10 for every game that you wanna play on your PS5, well, ooh, Lord Jesus, I feel like this is a slippery slope. I don't even know how to feel about it no more now that I done thought it all the way through. Like, imagine if it's more than one game and you wanna play them all on that PS5. You feel me? Like, the fuck is Sony smoking? Anywho, next thing on the docket, Privacy Spy rates Epic Games Store a 2.2 out of 10. This Privacy Spy, basically, it gives the full lowdown on how safe your information is with a company and or piece of software made by a company. And first things, reason why it got this low rating is because out of handling, the policy allows personally targeted or behavioral marketing. The service does not allow you to permanently delete your personal data. The service allows third-party access to private personal data. It's like, you get, it's not transparent enough at all about how it's using your data. And the collection of data is very clear, but only on certain and very few things. Not clear enough, basically. Is it clear why the service collects the personal data that it does? Only somewhat. Does the service allow the user to control whether personal data is collected or used for non-critical purposes on an opt-out basis, but only for some non-critical data and uses? Does the policy list the personal data it collects? Yes, but generally. That means it generalizes and not specifies exactly why or what data it collects. All of that is very suspicious, highly suspicious. And Epic Games, y'all gotta do better. You gotta understand, I've said it time and time again, you're stepping into a fray that you're inexperienced in. You're competing with Steam. You need to be on the level. You need to be on their level. And right now, you're doing great by drawing people in with free games, but until you can promise them that their information is safe, that damn it, you can't even fathom reaching Steam's level, let alone compete with them. And if you don't get this shit right here working right first, if you don't get this right first, you're going to end up being that one software people open once a week to get the free game and then forget they have it because they never opened it. So, and I ain't going to lie, I almost ended up in that, but I managed. Anyway, that needs to be considered, and y'all need to know about that as well, because information is the most important and valuable thing in our world right now, man. It's worth more than gold at this point, it seems like it. Anywho's, next on the docket, GamesIndustry.biz, Take-Two sues makers of Grand Theft Auto 3 and Vice City reverse engineering project. So that was this reverse engineering project by, RE3 project? I think the name of the people or whatnot, based on what the article told me. And they decided that they wanted to reverse engineer these two Grand Theft Auto games and make their own code so that they can update the game and make it playable on PC so people can actually play it with better controls, better load times, less glitches, etc. The fact that Take-Two is willing to sue these people and tell them to stop working on this project is trash because they ain't doing shit with the GTA. Oh wait, they're doing the remakes, right? Well then, okay, then if that's the case, this is good news. There has been rumors that they are working on remakes of GTA, I think it's 3, Vice City, and San Andreas. So if they are remaking these GTAs, it will be great that they cease and desist this, because that would mean that they don't want people to go and play this free reverse engineered, you know, project over what they're going to be selling on the market. So yeah, but that being said, at least get these people on board with you or consult them or something so to make sure that y'all don't fuck the remake up, because I need this remake to be good. I've been like debating, should I re-download GTA 5 and get the Vice City mod where they redid the entire game of Vice City, but I don't feel like it, and I want to replay those GTAs, but them shits was janky, bro. We put up with a lot of shit coming up that I forgot about, and I'm not really willing to go all the way back to 3, but I did enjoy 3 when I first played it, so there's that. And Vice City, hell yeah. You know, so it's just gonna take some doing, but let's hope that this is just a sign that they actually are working on this remake. Anywho's, PCGamer.com, next thing on the docket is Call of Duty Warzone cheater stars in an official anti-cheat ad and then keeps on cheating anyway. So yeah, Rushman360, who claimed he was hardware banned from Warzone, is still in the game, still cheating. Basically, he's using a spoofer for his hardware to give like false MAC addresses and whatnot so that he won't be presumed banned once again, and he just keeps cheating. And you know, until they make this is just gonna force them to make more intrusive anti-cheat software, and people, you know what I mean, are just people can't let things be good. They gotta stretch the rubber band until it breaks, and this is just one of those situations. So rip in peace. But I'm gonna be frankly honest with you, as far as like battle royales go, you know I don't care about no Warzone. Like, there's way better choices on the market. But as far as a free battle royale, Warzone will be up there as one of the best ones on the market, because it was better than the Black Ops one, and it's free. I mean, you can't really fuck with a game that's Call of Duty and it's free. Like, that's something that a lot of people gonna gravitate to regardless. So either way, yeah, that's pretty much the whole long and short of it. There's supposed to be more updates just in case. The writer Andy Chalk, which I read a lot of his works, has reached out to Activision for comment and will update if I receive a reply, is what he said, quote unquote. So we might get an update on this in the future, but as of right now, it seems like Call of Duty has an infinite cheating problem that they're trying their best to break. And let's hope that Activision can do something about it while there is a dumpster fire in front of them and behind them, because that whole Blizzard mess is a woo. But I don't want to talk about them this week. So anyway, yep, that is all the news that we got for y'all this week, and I appreciate you for stopping by. Thank you for listening to the podcast, thank you for subscribing to the podcast, and thank you for either watching it if you're on YouTube, for those who are on YouTube watching. And don't forget to check out my Twitch. I do stream almost every day but Sundays and Mondays. Just come and see me and I'll be there. I don't even know what I was doing right there, but it just came out like that. I don't know why. But anyway. I can't choose between Donda and Certified Lover Boy, because one, Donda is a great brainchild piece, work of art, like great music through and through, and Certified Lover Boy is the drizzy that we know and love, is what we came for. It's like when you buy a pizza, you don't expect it to have the nutritional properties of quinoa, you know what I mean? You just want it to be a pizza. And Drake is great fast food music, and I'm also a Young Money, you know, stand. It's YMC and B over here, okay? Ever since it was Cash Money and then it became Young Money, goddamn it, it's gonna always be Young Money. So yeah, it's plain and simple. Be mad at the ghosts if y'all want to. Yeah, I can't decide which one I like more. It is what it is. But that Fuji sample that Kanye did was so fucking fire though. Oh, alright, I'm finna go, y'all. Y'all take it easy and always remember the channel motto: intentions is the most important. Actions ain't nothing but loud, and words don't mean a damn thing. Y'all take care of yourselves and peace. Oh my God, bro, look at that pose. Do you know where that pose comes from? Oh my God! Bitch, I know you didn't. Eager, I know you didn't. Hold up. Hold up, yo! And we was just in here talking, man, get this, bro, this shit is too good. That shit's sick. Yeah! All right, little Josuke. Okay, little Josuke, hit him with the. That shit made my night, boy. That shit made my night.